today they took down every standard and everything seemed all right. But in Isaiah 5 it says, woe to them that call good evil and evil good, and put light for darkness, darkness for light, and bitter for sweet, and sweet for bitter. Honey, I begin to find out that everything I learned was wrong when I was a little boy, it seems to be all right now. And everything that was all right back then is wrong now. Honey, let me try to try to change everything, but I'm glad that God said, I'm the same yesterday, today, right? I'm God and I change not, thank God. But I want you to know tonight, the word of God says, you may think it's all right for this homosexual act and lesbianism and everything else that's going on in this world because they say the law says it's okay. But let me tell you right this, the word of God says, there's a way in the man that seemeth right, but the end thereof is the way of death today, thank God. But my Bible says, be holy for I am holy, and without holiness no man shall see God. Well, the Lord of the vineyard, he said, what? Who's he talking about? God the Father, of course. He said, what am I going to do? He said, I have but one son, and when they see him, they will reverence him and give me the fruit of the vineyard. But oh, what did they do? They said, when they seen the Lord Jesus Christ come and said, this is the Lord, this is the son of the heir, let us come and kill him and seize upon the inheritance. You see, they know that he was the son of God all the time, and the Sanhedrin said, if any man can confess the Lord Jesus, let him be put out of the synagogue. What did Nicodemus say, honey, in John chapter 3? He said, we know that there are man sent from God, for no man can do these miracles except God sent him. They know who he was, but they wasn't about to change. People today know that there's a heaven to gain, and they know there's a hell shelf, but they like sin. They like death, but I want you to know tonight, the word of God said the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. My friend, there's a payday coming, I want you to know. My friend, I thank God there's also a payday, brother, for us as we're trying to serve the Lord Jesus Christ. One of these days, thank God, Brother Terry, we can hear him say, well done, good faithful servant, carrying unto the joys of the Lord. But look today, Satan's got more to offer today, Sister Yule, than he's ever had in life. He's got computers to let your kids have, and they can look up sex films and everything else on them. He's got computers for them to play with before they even get out of diapers today, and look at the ball games and everything. Look at everything today is scheduled on Sunday to take your children out of God, away from the house of God. My friend, it's high time that people search us out the old path, as it says in the book of Isaiah, thus saith the Lord, I stand in the way, see, and ask for the old path, and walk therein, ye shall find peace for your soul. But they said, we will not walk therein. Brother, the word of God says there's pleasure in sin for a season. But my friend, one of these days before long, it's going to come to a head. Look what's happened in America today. America's burned up, and there's floods, and there's hurricanes, and everything else. Yet last week, I want you to know Mexico had three major earthquakes in 1 week. My friend, ain't that the signs of the end of time? There'll be manifestos and earthquakes and divers places. All these point to the coming of Jesus Christ. I bring it down to judgment upon this world. A good time is over for America. Things is not going to get better, but things is going to wax worse and worse. And the only peace you're going to have today is in the Lord Jesus Christ. You need to say, I got my throat off, and my mind's made up. I'm going to serve the Lord. I'm going to serve God. Well, they tell Jesus, I mean, but the husband men, they said, this is the heir. Come, let us kill him, and say, the inheritance shall be ours. My friend, let me tell you, that's what today. They don't want to serve the Lord Jesus Christ because they got the world today, Brother Drake, just the way they want it. Just like they had it back in them days. The rich man's got it all sewed up now, and they want God who they want in power, and they don't want nothing to do with the Lord Jesus Christ. But let me tell you one thing, they're unbelief when Jesus Christ gets ready to come. We'll slow him down 1 millisecond. He'll be right here like he said again. He said, I'll come again, and I'll receive my own, thank God, that right there he may be also. We got something to look forward to today, thank God. We got a heaven to gain, thank God, in one of these days. We shall see him as he is, thank God. And we're going to have a glorified body, thank God. But they took him and they killed him and cast him out of the vineyard, took him out, and they thought it done away with the Lord. But I like that song Brother Terry sang. He didn't stay dead and he won't stay gone. I am about ready to come, thank God. Aren't you glad tonight when you lay your head upon that pillow, thank God, that you know your sins are done the blood, thank God, and you've got something to look forward to. What the Paul said, if we only had hope in Christ Jesus in this world, how we all made would be most miserable. But I've got a payday coming, thank God, and I'm not about to cast it away. Hebrews said, cast not away your confidence, which has a great recompense and reward, sister Elsie. Honey, we've come too far. We've been through too many valleys. We've crossed too many rivers. We've been brought through too many fires. I have to turn back now. We're almost there. They hold up your hands and say, I'm in charge of the king. That he that's in the world, I've come this far, and I'm not about to turn around. I'm anchored in Jesus, and I'm anchored in faith. I'm anchored in Jesus, and I thank God. I'll tell you, I've vested in him, and he's in me, thank God. I began to talk to him last night, I tell him, Lord, I don't see how you keep up with everything. And I said, Lord, I know you're all coming. I wouldn't have your job if you offered it to me. I bet that was a laugh. He said, you pour in your thing, you better turn the light switch off and on. I said, brother, listen, but I'm glad we serve a God tonight with all power in the hand. Lord, all about us, with the very hairs of our head. Boys, listen, I love that. He didn't stay dead, and he's not going to stay gone. He's sitting at the right hand of the Father today, making intercession for you and I. And I want you to know today that Jesus is not sitting on that throne. I'm wringing his hands, oh, Daddy, look. I went down there and walked among them for 33 and a half years, and I'm the one that killed me out of the vineyard. You see, Jesus knew what they was going to do. They were going to kill him and throw him out of the vineyard. But they didn't do away with the Lord, did they? For on the third day, thank God, he rose. He went upon the dead. Feeling the great thing, and I am the soul of the beaten, thank God. And it goes tonight that you've got a blessed home and a blessed assurance. That's your name in the Lamb's Book of Life, thank God.